Here today with Berkeley City Councilperson Colleen Gravelin, who's running for reelection. How are you doing today?
Great, thank you, Crystal.
Can you talk a little bit about how you got to be on City Council and why you're running again?
Sure. Councilwoman Tina Egger moved out of the City of Berkeley, so they had to appoint someone to finish out her term. So I put my name in, and here we are. It's been a very illuminating year and a half to become acquainted with how the City of Berkeley works. And it's been a pleasure. So as in any new job, it takes about that long to feel like you know what you're doing and figure out the system. So I would really like to take what I've learned and help keep Berkeley moving forward for the next 4 years.
Now, what do you think have been some of the accomplishments of the past year and a half?
Well, I won't take any credit for the accomplishments. I joined a team that's really committed to making things better for Berkeley in the best way that we can. Things I'm most proud of is we have an amazing group of people that work behind the scenes every day to just make Berkeley happen. And it's been a pleasure to learn how to collaborate with them and with the community, because again, I don't deserve any credit for anything that Berkeley does well. If we can't make the people appreciate what we're doing and help work with the people that are doing, whose daily job is to make it happen, then I can't be an effective city council person.
Now, if you're reelected, what are some of the issues that you want to work on?
I really wish I had a flashy answer for this, but mm-hmm. The only one is infrastructure. We have to address infrastructure. It's time to be on a team that will lead on this question instead of leaving it for the next group down the road to deal with. And I've touched on communication in the past because there's so many modes of communication. It's become one of my favorite questions to ask people. How do you find out about what's happening in Berkeley? And it's different per each person I talk to. So as a city, we have to be able to address each of those modes of communication. And we're getting better every day. The citizens let us know what they like to hear and what they don't like to hear. So it's an ongoing process they want to help improve, and especially as we tackle all of our infrastructure situations that are happening around us.
Now, can you talk a little bit about what some of your background and experiences that you bring to the table?
Sure. Well, I received an undergraduate degree in communications from Michigan State, and then I went on to get a master's degree in clinical psychology, after which I immediately got married and started a family. So the only way I've put those to work has been on my children, which has been the best experience, and I feel very blessed to be able to have been at home with them for the past 15 years. I've got 5 kids, their ages 4 to 14, and I refuse to answer the question that I'm just a mom, because it is the best full-time job I've ever had, the most humbling, and I'm very grateful to be able to do it.
Have you had any other community involvement?
In 2012, I was the treasurer of Taxpayers for Berkeley's Future, where we addressed the millage situation. As the economy went down, so did the revenues to the city. So we came to the people and asked to increase the millage, which was successful. So I did have that experience and have been on a couple focus groups as well, which is what led me to put my name in for the open seat to begin with, having those experiences. And I was very impressed with the way our leadership of Berkeley laid on the table transparently where we were as a city. And I thought that was a team I would like to be part of and relate to the citizens as well and continue that respectful relationship with our community.
There is some contention for this seat. Why should people vote for you?
Well, for all the reasons I've listed so far, and I really do tend to be pretty central on most things. So when I say I love Berkeley, I love the Berkeley I moved to 8 years ago, and Berkeley's changing. We have a lot of new families moving in. We have a lot of tough problems to deal with, and we have a lot of new ideas coming at us as what Berkeley could be or should be. I believe we have an opportunity to walk the balance, to respect where we were, but yet still move forward, to be relevant going forward, and to offer things to new families. And I believe I have the personality and the temperament and the desire to find that balance.
Now, if people want more information about you and your campaign, where do they go?
I have an information Facebook page set up, so you can go to facebook.com/keepcolleen, or in the Facebook search bar, you can just search for @keepcolleen. I also have an email address. It's keepcolleenoncouncil@gmail.com. Those are probably the best two ways to get in touch with me.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you, Crystal.